Spirelli Paranormal Investigations, Season 1, Episodes 1 through 6. Written by Kate Baray. Narrated by Roberto Scarlato. Episode 1. Chapter 1. Jack fiddled with the inner workings of his ancient cash register. He needed a newer machine to better track sales because, surprisingly, the junk shop actually had a few sales to track. Who knew boxes of garage sale rejects would be so popular? The store hours were erratic, and the stock ranged from recycled trash to bizarre trinkets, yet the store still received stellar online consumer reviews. It didn't have a website, so how did the yuppies, hipsters, whoever the hell was writing the reviews, find it?
"You know, that car outside looks like it needs a little work. I might know a guy, if you're interested."
5 foot and a lot, the woman attached to the voice would be hard to miss, with her fiery red hair and overly bright green eyes. Jack left his bar stool perch behind the counter and had a long look at her. He'd missed her entering the store, and her voice had startled him. Quite a task, considering he had a tight ward on the store, and he was hardly an unobservant guy.
"How can I help you?"
Jack worked to produce a convincingly relaxed tone. Face expressionless, the redhead said,
"I'm here to apply for the position."
"We're not hiring at the moment."
When she didn't reply and she also didn't leave, he added,
"Look around. We're a small shop, but maybe something will catch your eye."
Sure, the junk shop was a retail location, but it had begun primarily as a front for Jack's work with the magic-using community. A discreet physical location was a bonus when meeting with clients who wanted to stay under the radar. He looked around the small store. For a front, it was becoming increasingly and uncomfortably popular. She looked around.
I'm not here for bric-a-brac. I'm sure you've got a position open. My sources are excellent."
Jack hadn't posted the position. Where would he? He could just imagine how that ad would read. "Wanted, paranormal investigator's assistant. Complete discretion and some ass-kicking required. Part-time help in the junk shop mandatory. A high tolerance for the unexplainable preferred." No. And Jack had only mentioned to a select few that he was looking to hire. His highest-ranking Inter-Pack Policing Cooperative contact, Harrington, the Texas Pack leader, John Braxton, and IPPC's temporary chief of security for the Prague Library, Ewan Campbell.
"Who's your reference?"
"My stealth entry into the store wasn't reference enough?"
She gave him a toothy smile. That smile made him incredibly uncomfortable. Green eyes, creepy feeling. Alarm bells were ringing. Fuck. His stealthy green-eyed Amazon was a dragon. He'd bet cash on it. He stared back without answering. She shrugged.
"Lachlan McLeland. But that might not be entirely to my benefit when you check my references."
"Head of the McLeland clan?"
The guy led a powerful clan of dragons, but he was also a dick with a crap sense of humor, and Jack didn't see him being particularly enlightened about female employees. Although he was surprised Ewan had mentioned Jack's staffing needs to his clan leader. She hesitated before responding.
"We're from the same clan."
"Oh, fuck. Dragon. He knew it. You want the job?"
She raised an eyebrow.
"I'm here, having this conversation with you."
Her non-answers were annoying as hell. More importantly, he didn't see them becoming less annoying with time and proximity.
"Pass." Jack turned back to the register.
"Wait, yes, I would like the job."
She continued to speak to his back.
"Please, I would very much like this job."
Slowly, Jack turned around. "And tell me why I should hire you. Besides your stealth entry into a warded store, that only tells me you're a thief." A brief flicker of fiery green flashed in her eyes, but quickly dimmed.
"I'm unemployed and unable to return to my previous employer, which makes me highly motivated to be successful here. Also, I understand you're looking for muscle. My combat skills are excellent.
She blinked.
I can demonstrate.
She gave him another smile with just a shade too many teeth. No thanks. A dragon kicking my very human ass isn't much of a demonstration. Besides, I'd hate for us to break my bric-a-brac.
Jack sat down behind the counter and picked up a pen. Having a dragon would be a huge tactical advantage in most fights, regardless of technical competence.
Talk to Lachlan. Whatever else he might say, he'll tell you I'm honest and hardworking.
She placed a slight emphasis on honest. She swallowed, the first sign of nervousness she'd displayed since walking into his store.
Please.
Apparently he'd hit a nerve when he'd compared her to a thief. A highly motivated, well-connected dragon employee, he'd be an idiot to walk away just because she wasn't exactly right. Especially since he didn't know what exactly right was. What type of person wouldn't drive him nuts with continuous contact? The shelf life of most of his relationships, regardless of the type, was pretty short.
What's your name?
Marin.
She didn't offer her hand. Jack knew the right answer, yet still he hesitated.
Damn.
He had a job coming up day after tomorrow that could use some dragon muscle.
All right, Marin. Come back tomorrow at 10. If your reference comes through, we'll discuss employment terms.
He narrowed his eyes. I don't pay well. She ducked her chin once in acknowledgement and headed out the door. This time, Jack saw her pass through the ward, and a shower of green sparks, visible only to him, fell in her wake. He felt a corresponding pinch from the ring he wore on his right hand. No way he'd missed the ward triggering when she'd first entered the store. If this whole thing worked out and she joined Spirelli Paranormal Investigations, that was one of his first questions. Jack picked up his cell and scrolled through his contacts, looking for Ewan's number. Jack was pretty sure Ewan would put him in touch with Lachlan. After a quick mental calculation, adding 7 hours to account for prog time, Jack decided it wasn't too late and dialed Ewan's number. Ewan answered on the first ring.
Jack, what's up?
Hey, Ewan. Any chance you could put me in touch with Lachlan? I had someone come by the shop asking about that assistance job. Remember I told you I was looking for someone?
Lachlan came up as a reference.
Sure. Background noise filtered in. Heads up, you're on speaker.
Thanks, man. You might actually know her. She's from your clan.
A tall redhead named Marin.
The background noise abruptly disappeared. Ewan must have turned the speaker function off and picked up his phone.
Yeah.
The word came out so short, it almost sounded like a grunt. Something about Marin had drastically changed the tone of their conversation. Jack contemplated for a split second whether to ask. He closed his eyes. Had he lost his mind? After a few seconds of silence, Ewan said,
Marin is my daughter.
Jack sat on his favorite bar stool, the one positioned in front of the shop's register. Careful to make his tone as neutral as possible, he said,
I didn't know that.
Clearly.
Jack didn't get it. Ewan seemed pissed, but the guy hadn't said a word about not hiring his kid. Since Jack wasn't eager to get singed or mutilated due to an unfortunate miscommunication, clarification was the wisest course.
So, are you telling me you don't want me to hire her?
Not at all.
Jesus, really? Jack rolled his shoulders.
Are you telling me you want me to hire her?
What did you want to know?
Ewan's voice had lost some of its edge.
Okay.
Jack figured Ewan had enough patience for about 2 questions. So he erred on the side of caution and limited himself to 1.
Would you recommend Marin for the job?
Yes. We done?
Good enough.
Yeah, thanks again.
As he pocketed his phone, he caught a flash of movement out of the corner of his eye.
staring at the now empty shop floor, he said, "I know you're there, little guy. You better be glad I know what rat poison does." He couldn't commit to chemical warfare, even in the pursuit of pest control. It was a weird quirk. Whatever. People who used rat poison.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.